Hello viewers, welcome back to my channel. I am Neha Pariyani. So from today we are going to start the practice sessions for accountancy class 12. Okay, and we are starting with partnership chapter, right? So in partnership we have five different chapters. In that, first one is basic concepts chapter, right? So we will start with this. Okay, so today's topic is partners capital account, right? So we already have a detailed explanation video of this topic on my channel. Okay, so there we have totally discussed this in detail, like the concept of it, the format of it, okay, and the concepts relating to partnership, right? So in the practice sessions, what we are going to do is we are going to solve all the textbook problems. Okay, so I'm referring this textbook from NCERT board. Okay, so I will refer this textbook, and whatever the questions are there in this, so we will be going on solving them. Okay, so I will open it now. Okay, so this is the question here, right? So if you want, you can take the screenshot if you don't have the book with you. Okay, so there are two questions relating to the partner's capital account given in your textbook. Let us solve both of them today, right? So before that, I would like to explain you something about partner's capital account. Okay, so partner's capital accounts in the partnership firm can be maintained by two methods, right? So first one is fixed capital method and the another one is fluctuating capital method. Okay, in the fixed capital method, we will prepare two different accounts, right? One is capital account and another one is current account. Okay, in the fixed capital method, the capital in the fixed in the capital account will not change. Okay, the capitals here will be fixed, right? So that is why we will prepare two different accounts. Okay, and the another one is the fluctuating capital method. In that, we will prepare only one partner's capital account. Okay, it is the combination of capital account and current account of the fixed method, right? So if you want to know its format and all, then you can check out my explanation video on this topic. Its link will be provided in the description box below and also at the end of this video. Okay, you can check it out, right? So we are going to start with the problem today. So Tripathi and Chauhan are partners in a firm sharing profits and losses in the ratio of 3:2. Okay, basically there are two partners in the firm. They are solving, they are sharing the profits in 3:2 ratio. Okay, their capitals were 60,000 and 40,000 as on January 1, 2005. Okay, during the year they earned a profit of rupees 30,000. Okay, according to the partnership deed, both the partners are entitled to rupees 1,000 per month as salary and 5% interest on their capital. Okay, then they are also to be charged an interest of 5% on their drawings. Irrespective of the period, which is rupees 12,000 for Tripathi and 8,000 for Chauhan. So amount of drawings is given here, right? Then prepare partners account when capitals are fixed. Okay, so we have to follow the fixed capital method for preparing the partner's capital account. Okay, so let us do it. As I told you, in the fixed capital method, we have to prepare two different accounts, partner's capital account and partner's current account. Okay, in the partner's capital account, we should only take the entries relating to the capital, right? So in the question, they have mentioned, right, their capitals were 60,000 and 40,000, right? So we should take it here. Right, capital is our liability, right? So always the liabilities of the opening balance of the liability account starts with the credit side. Okay, so take it as balance brought down. Okay, mention 60,000 rupees in the Tripathi's column and 40,000 rupees in Chauhan's column. Okay, so other than this, we don't have any entry relating to the capital. Okay, suppose in question additional capital was given, then we would have taken it here. Okay, or else if there were permanent drawings given in the question, then we would have taken on the debit side of the capital account. Okay, but here other than the opening capital, nothing else is given. Okay, so we will just close this account now. Only one entry will appear here. Okay, 60,000 and 40,000. Right? Here also 60,000 and 40,000. So balancing figure or balance carried down will also be same. 60,000 and 40,000. Okay? For all other transactions like salary, like interest on capital, for all those things we have to prepare partner's current account. Okay, we are doing this in the fixed capital method, right? So then we have to prepare partner's capital account. Okay, now again refer the question. So we have taken the entry relating to capital in the capital account, right? So next they are telling during the year they earn a profit of rupees 30,000. Okay, so this profit has to be distributed among both the partners, Tripathi and Chauhan, okay, in this ratio, 3:2 ratio, which is given in the question. Okay, now you have to remember that whatever the partner receives from the firm has to be recorded on the credit side. Okay, and whatever the partner pays to the firm will be recorded on the debit side. Okay, now we have to distribute the profit to the partners, right? So obviously partner will receive profit from the firm, right? So we will take it on the credit side. Okay, so we can take it as profit, in bracket you can mention P&L appropriation account. Okay, this profit we have got from P&L appropriation account. Okay, how to do this, again we will learn this in my upcoming sessions, right? So the profit here is 30,000 rupees. It has to be distributed in their ratio. So ratio is 3:2. Okay, so I'll show you how to distribute it. 30,000 into 3/5 for Tripathi. Okay, total, see, ratio is 3:2. Okay, so 3 plus 2 is 5, right? If we divide the profits in the 5 parts, then 3 parts belongs to Tripathi and 2 parts belongs to Chauhan. Okay, so that is why for Tripathi total profits are 30,000, out of that 3 parts out of 5. Okay, then for Chauhan, so 30,000 into 2/5. Okay, then just simplify this and we will get the amount as rupees 18,000 and 12,000. Okay, so this is how you will distribute the profits in their ratio. Clear? Then, according to partnership deed, both the partners are entitled to a salary of 1,000 per month and 5% interest on the capital. Okay, so again, the partners will receive salary from the firm, right? So they don't pay salary to the firm, right? They will receive it. So on the credit side, salary, so 1,000 rupees per month. Okay, so there are 12 months. So 1,000 into 12 will be 12,000 for both the partners. Clear? Then, interest on capital is 5%. Okay, we know the amount of capital here. Okay, 60,000 and 40,000. On that 5% interest has to be provided. Okay, now the firm will provide 5% interest on capital to the partners. Okay, partners have made investment, their money, they have invested their money into the business. Okay, on that money the firm will give them interest. Clear? So again, the partners receives 5% interest from the firm. So receives, right? So that is why on the credit side, interest on capital. Okay, so for Tripathi, 60,000 rupees is his capital. Okay, so 5% of that will be 3,000 rupees. Okay, and Chauhan, rupees 40,000 is his capital and 5% of that will be rupees 2,000. Okay, then it is given that they also charged interest of 5% on their drawings. Okay, irrespective of the period, which is rupees 12,000 for Tripathi and 8,000 for Chauhan. Okay, so the amount of drawings is given, right? Along with that, they are telling 5% interest on drawings should also be provided. Okay, now try to understand, when the partner withdraws some of the amount, okay, so in future he has to pay back that amount to the firm, right? Currently, he may withdraw it. He may receive that amount from the firm, okay? But it is not his permanent drawings, right? He has to give back or pay back that amount to the firm, okay? So, he will pay that amount, okay? That is why record it on the debit side. First, record drawings. Amount of drawings is given, right? 12,000 for Tripathi and 8,000 for Chauhan, right? Then, we also have to charge interest on drawings. Okay, again, interest on drawings has to be paid by the partner to the firm. Why? Because partner is using firm's money here, right? So that is why partner will pay interest on drawings, okay, till the time he is using that amount, that withdrawal amount. Okay, so 5% has to be charged. 12,000 rupees is the drawings of Tripathi. Out of that 5%, 5 by 100, okay, so that will be rupees 600, right? And 8,000 rupees is the drawings of Chauhan. Okay, 5% of that will be rupees 400. Clear? Now, everything is recorded here. Okay, so we have recorded everything. Now, just total both the amount columns. Okay, and see which side is bigger. Okay, here the credit side is bigger when you total it. Okay, so the total of Tripathi is rupees 33,000. And total of Chauhan is 26,000. Okay. First mention the same here. 33,000 and 26,000. Okay. Now deduct these amount from 33,000. So we will get a balancing figure. Okay. The balancing figure here is 20,400. Okay. And balancing figure of Chauhan is 17,600. Okay. We call it as balance carried down. Clear? So this is how we prepare partner's capital account under fixed method. Okay, so in this question they have only asked to prepare capital accounts under fixed method, right? But for better understanding we will use the same question, okay, and we will also prepare partner's capital account in the fluctuating method, right? So that you can easily get to know the difference. Okay, now we are preparing partner's capital account in the fluctuating method. Okay, so this capital account is just the combination of both of these accounts. Okay, here separately we are showing the capital entries, right? Here in this method we will show the capital entry also in the same account. That is why we will prepare only one account here. Okay, so we will refer the question. Okay, first of all we had balance brought down, right? Capital. Remember, always capital account starts with the balance brought down. That is capital brought by the partners. Okay. 60,000 and 40,000. Okay. After that, profit was given in the question. Right. Total 30,000 profit was given. That has to be distributed among Tripathi and Chauhan in the ratio 3:2. We have already done the calculations here. Right. You can mention the same amount. 18,000 and 12,000. So salary 1,000 per month. So for 12 months it will be 12,000 rupees for both the partners. Right. So after salary, interest on capital was given. Okay. Interest on capital. We have done all the calculations. Right. So calculations will not be affected. Everything will be same. Amount, everything will be same. Okay. So 3,000 and 2,000. 5% on their capitals. Clear? Then we had the drawings transaction, right? So drawings were made, drawings on the debit side, because sooner or later the partner has to pay the drawings amount back to the firm. Okay, he has to pay back that amount. Okay, so 12,000 and 8,000, right? Then along with drawings he also has to pay interest on drawings. Okay, we have done the calculations. So 600 and 400. Okay, so we have just combined both of these accounts and we have prepared another account. So this is fluctuating method. Clear? So now total this, okay, and check which side balance is more. Again, the balance is more on the credit side. Okay, so the total of all these will be 93,000. Okay, and here the total will be 66,000, right? So mention the same amount here, 93,000 and 66,000. Balancing figure, if you deduct these amounts here, will be 80,400 and 57,600. We call it as balance carried down, balancing figure. Okay. Now, if you want to cross check, you can do it. Okay. See, total of six these two accounts, 60,000 and 33,000 will be 93,000, right? 40,000 plus 26,000 will be 66,000. Okay. Even the balance carried down, right? So even that will be same balance carried down of the capital account and current account. Just add both of this. Your balance carried down in the capital account of fluctuating method will be same. Okay. So this account is just combination of both of these, right? So next, now we will solve the second problem. Okay. Anubha and Kajal are partners of a firm sharing profits and losses in the ratio of 2:1. Okay. Their capitals were 90,000 and 60,000. The profit during the year was ₹45,000. Right. Then, according to partnership deed, both partners are allowed salary of ₹700 per month to Anubha and ₹500 per month to Kajal. Okay. Interest allowed on capital at 5% per annum. The drawings at the period, at the end of the period, were ₹8,500 for Anubha and ₹6,500 for Kajal. Okay. Interest on drawings to be charged at 5% per annum on drawings. Okay. Then partners capital account, prepare partners capital accounts assuming that the capital accounts are fluctuating. Okay. So here they have asked us to prepare the capital account in the fluctuating capital method. Right. So first we will do the fluctuating method. Then again we will do the fixed method for this problem also. Okay. So first we'll start with the fluctuating method. Fluctuating method. Okay. So as I already told you, partners capital account starts with the balance brought down. That is the capital of the partners. Okay. Capital given in the question is 90,000 and 60,000 rupees. Clear? Then the profits of the firm are given. Okay. So profits for the year were ₹45,000. Okay. Now this again has to be distributed between both the partners in their ratio. That is 2:1. Right. So we have to distribute 45,000 in the ratio of 2:1. Profit, P&L, appropriation, account. Okay. So 45,000 rupees is the total profits into 2/3 for Anubha and 45,000 into 1/3 for Kajal. Okay. So total 2 + 1 = 3, right? So two parts belongs to Anubha and one part belongs to Kajal. Okay. So when you simplify this, you get the amount as 30,000 and 15,000. Okay. Then, so according to partnership deed, we have to give salaries to the partners, right? 700 per month to Anubha and 500 per month to Kajal. Okay. Right. So 700 rupees for 1 month, it means for 12 months, it will be first mentioned here. Salaries. So 700 for 1 month means for 12 months it will be 8,400 rupees. Okay. And for Kajal it will be 3,000 rupees. 500 per month means for 12 months it will be 3,000 rupees. Okay. Now salaries is completed. Right. Then we have interest allowed on capital at 5% per annum. Okay. So we have to provide interest on capital. Okay. So again, interest on capital on the credit side. Right. So capital of Anubha is 90,000 into 5/100. Right. So that will be ₹4,500. Okay. And interest of capital of Kajal is 60,000 rupees into 5% of that will be ₹3,000. Fine. Then next, okay, the drawings of both the partners are given, ₹8,500 for Anubha and ₹6,500 for Kajal. Okay, along with that, interest on drawings is 5% per annum. Okay, so we know drawings amount the partners has to pay, that is why drawings on the debit side. So drawings, ₹8,500 and rupees 6500. Okay, now interest on drawings, right? So here drawings of Anubha is 8500 into 5 by 100. Okay, that will be rupees 425. Okay, and 6500 into 5 by 100 will be rupees 325. Clear? Okay, now everything from the question is recorded. Now again, total both the amount columns and check which side is bigger. So here obviously credit side is bigger. Okay, total of Anubha will be rupees 1,32,900, right? Then total of Kajal will be rupees 84,000. Okay, write the same amount here, 1,32,900 and 84,000. Now deduct these amounts from 1,32,900. So we get a balancing figure. Okay, that is 1,23,975 for Anubha. Okay, and for Kajal 77,175. Okay, so this we call it as balance carried down, balancing figure. Clear? So this is how we prepare capital account in the fluctuating method. Now let us use the same question and prepare capital accounts in the fixed method. Okay, so for here we know that in the fixed capital method two accounts should be prepared. In partner's capital account we should only take the entry relating to the capital. Okay, so balance brought down. Capital of Anubha is 90,000 and Kajal is 60,000. Okay, 90,000 and 60,000. Again in this question any additional capital is not given, right? Any permanent drawings are not given. Okay, so just close it. 90,000 and 60,000. Okay, so balance carried down will also be same. Balancing figure 90,000 and 60,000. Okay, so now if you know this and if you know this balancing figure, you can easily come to know that what would be the balancing figure of current account. Okay, so just to deduct 90,000 from this, that same amount will be the balancing figure of current account. So let us prepare the current account now. Okay, so for preparing this you can refer fluctuating method capital account itself. Okay, so just leave this entry, balance brought down entry, just leave this. Remaining all entries you can take as it is. Okay, first we have profit, so P&L appropriation account. Okay, profit is 30,000 for Anubha and 15,000 for Kajal. Okay, then we have salaries, 8,400 and 3,000. Salaries 8,400 and 3,000. Okay, then we have interest on capital. Again calculation, everything is done, take the same amount. Okay, interest on capital 4,500 and 3,000. Okay, now on the debit side, drawings and interest on drawings both should be taken here. Okay, drawings 8,500 and 6,500. Okay, interest on drawings 425 and 325 rupees. Clear? Okay, now total both the amount columns. Again here we have more balance on the credit side. Okay, total here will be 42,900 and here 24,000. 42,900, 24,000. Okay, so then the balancing figure here will be 33,975 and 17,175. You can always use the calculator for calculations. Okay, so this is balance carried down, balancing figure. Okay, so now no matter the question is given in which method, either it's given in the fluctuating method or fixed method, you are ready to solve it in the both the methods. Okay, so only two questions are given in your textbook relating to partner's capital account. Okay, so the next topic in your textbook is distribution of profits, nothing but profit and loss appropriation account. Okay, so in tomorrow's session, in the next practice session, we are going to solve these problems. Okay, so do watch the next session as well. Thanks for watching.